Hi, this is Rob with Eco-Panels of Tennessee, and today I wanted to kind of go over, you know, what does our panel look like, kind of the anatomy of a panel, what are the different parts, how do they go together, and kind of give you a little bit more detail, I guess, on some of the components and parts that go into making an eco-panel. So first, let's just start with a panel. I've got a wall panel. Now this is a short wall panel because for demonstration purposes, I don't want to be hoisting up an eight or nine foot panel here to show you. That makes it much more difficult for me to flip around. So different parts of an eco panel. This is the inside of the panel. This is a half inch piece of OSB. The outside of this panel also has a half inch piece of OSB. And in the center of the panel is closed cell foam that we use. And in other videos, we talk a little bit more detail about the foam and how it reacts and what it does. But this is a 4.5 inch thick total thickness panel. This has an R value of 26 on this particular one. Now we also make a 6.5 inch thick panel that is pretty much constructed the same, just a thicker thickness of foam in the center, and that has an R value of 40. This panel also, on the end of the panel where they join together with another panel, has a tongue and groove profile. So when we shoot the foam, it has a raised part, a tongue. It has a recessed part that's the groove, and that matches the other side so that when these two go together, that's creating a good seal. Now with your Eco-Panels package, we send an adhesive foam and a foam gun so that when you are assembling this on site or your builder, that you would put the adhesive foam here in this groove, and then you would shoot another line here along this tongue so that when these two panels go together, we're going to get an even better seal that's going to keep that cold air out of your house. Now, we use a cam lock system, and this panel has a cam lock in it. So I'll kind of show you how that operates. Your package also comes with a cam lock key. We like to say it's the key to the house. So once the panels go together, you have the hook part of the cam lock, and then you have the latch part on the other side. So that when this goes together, this grabs the latch, and then I don't know if you can see this, but if you look closely, it grabs it and then it pulls. So it doesn't just clamp down on it, it actually grabs it and then goes in. So it's grabbing that latch and then pulling that toward it. Actually, each of these cam locks is rated at 450 pounds of pulling capacity. In an 8 foot panel, there would be 4 sets up and down. So you'd be about every 2 foot. So you'd have 2, 4, 6, 8, and you'd have 4 sets. 9 foot panel, you'd have 5 sets, 10 foot panel, and so on. Let me kind of show you how these two lock together. I'll hook these two panels together. So you put them together like that. You turn the key and lock them, and that is now locked together. So another thing to mention on kind of the anatomy of a panel is this electrical box. So one of the things that we do at Eco-Panels of Tennessee is we place your electrical box needs in the SIP panel walls according to where you desire them to be. This can be an outlet plug, it could be the plug for the television up high. It could be a higher plug that's, say, above a kitchen cabinet or something if your kitchen's on an outside wall. We can also do light sconces. We can do switch boxes. So if you had like a 3-gang switch, it would be a different type of box that we would install. And then this box has a conduit chase that connects from the box to the end of the panel. So if it's on a crawl space or a basement, many times these chases would go down so that those can be accessed under the, the crawl space area or the basement. If it's on a slab, those chases may go up so that they can be accessed at the top of the wall to tie the different plugs together once you're running your wiring. We can explain more. Every house is different, so when we talk about your particular project, we can kind of get into those details. Another thing that we do is this panel I showed you had the OSB on both sides. Quite a few of the panels that we make have the zip sheathing on the outside. So it has the OSB on the inside and then the zip on the outside. This is a Huber Zip product, and you can look that up on the internet. The zip has a waterproof coating already on the OSB. So if you use the zip system and you use their tape at the seams, you don't have to use like a Tyvek house wrap. It replaces that, makes it very tight. This is waterproof, a lot of our customers choose that. I would say probably 60-70% of the houses that we make have this zip on the outside. So talk to us about that as well. Now, a couple other things. The bottom of the wall panel will have a void in it like this. So this void sets over top of the sill plate on your foundation. So let's imagine that this is a subfloor. There would be a sill plate here that would be a 2x4 in the case of this size panel. This panel would then fit over top of that 2x4, flush with the outside of your subfloor, and then this would be attached with screws or nails to attach the wall panel system to the subfloor properly. And there's some details on that in our assembly manual that we'll be glad to share with you. A little different if it's a slab, but we can go over those details with you, but essentially kind of the same thing. The second part of that is the top plate. And one of these panels I brought over here has a top plate. That's this one. So bottom plate we talked about here. The top of the panel will have a plate embedded in it. So this top plate is part of the upper part of the panel. So that is your first plate for when you're going to set your second floor or your roof system on top of the wall. In our assembly manual, we have details on where you add a secondary plate on top of this to kind of tie everything together. So you have two plates at the top of the wall like you would in standard construction. The first plate, though, is already embedded inside the panel and already done for you. As far as the rest of the assembly goes, one other thing I'd like to mention is the corners. We are the only panel company that has a patent on a SIP corner. And I'd like you to see, this is foam. I want you to see how this foam is all the way around this corner. Corners are the most notorious places for a home to leak energy. If you use a thermal imaging camera on a conventional house, the corners just light up. There's just not really a great way to get insulation in there. It's really hard to do. We have removed that area of suspect on air infiltration and heat loss by making a solid SIP panel corner. Eco-Panels is the only company that does this. We have the patent on this, and we want to make sure we're the only company doing this, and that's why we have the patent. So that kind of gives you some basic ideas on what our wall panels look like, the different component pieces that make up a panel. We'd be happy to share more information with you. You can shoot us an email, you can give us a call, you can text us. We can send you our assembly manual that has a lot of pages. I don't know, it's 100 and something pages with a lot of pictures, by the way, which I enjoy books with pictures, that kind of show you how this all goes together. And certainly we'd love to just talk with you about your project. You know, I always tell people that every house is different, which is one of the really cool things about our jobs is we do such a variety. Every home is a little different. So there'll be some nuances. Some homes have beam pockets. Some houses have, there's always some specialty things, and we can handle that too. We're not just cranking out stock panels and say, so sorry, this is all we do. We are able to custom adapt the panels to your specific design. So contact us. We'd love to hear more about your project, and you can we can kind of go over some details that might be specific to you. We're going to post the contact information here in just a second, and look forward to hearing from you.